be a part of what we're doing here at WBONTV.com and advertise with us, email us at information@WBONTV.com or send us a message on Facebook or Twitter. Our video stories now have over 1 million organic views and over 1 million people reached organically. Get watched, get noticed, get Richmond's very own, WBONTV.com.
From the studios of WBONTV.com, I'm Marissa Hempel, and this is your Wednesday afternoon news brief. The city of Richmond will finally have a new city manager after months of salary negotiation and searches. Last night, the city commission agreed to hire Rob Meinrich as the new manager. All the commissioners, with the exception of Morgan Eves, voted in favor of his hiring. He will start June 25th at a salary of $95,000 annually. Meinrich spoke to WBON-TV and says he is ready for the new position. He's currently the director of Boonesboro State Park. The city of Richmond will also be hiring 2 new code enforcement officers for the codes department, as well as purchasing new security gates for some of the city-owned parking lots. There was also the first reading of the city's fiscal year 2019 budget that includes a 4% raise across the board for city employees. After a large influx of kittens turned up at the Estill Animals shelter in Ravenna this week, shelter officials had to set a euthanization date as they simply had no room to house all the furry friends. Director Tommy Mullen told WBON-TV they even had to house the cats in the dog kennels because of lack of space, but the animals are now safe because the youth date is canceled for now. Mullen also responded to those that say it's a management issue that results in the shelter being overcrowded from time to time, and he says that this is a spay-neuter issue instead. He also reports that the shelter is one of the lowest youth rates statewide, if not the lowest. Despite the new adoptions, all cats and kittens are still free at the shelter, and Mullen says unless a huge amount of drop-offs occur again, the youth date will not take place this Friday. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says the Senate is on track for a vote to legalize the crop that comes from the same plant that produces marijuana. The Senate Agriculture Committee is scheduled to consider the Farm Bill Wednesday. It will include a provision to remove hemp from a list of Schedule 1 controlled substances, making it legal for farmers to grow and sell it. Although far from becoming law, it's noted progress for an idea that has faced staunch opposition among conservative lawmakers. McConnell says he's won the argument that hemp is not about marijuana. Now, he says he just needs it to become law, adding that it's well situated in a position to make that happen. A fourth person has been taken into custody in connection with the adult kidnapping and knife assault in Montgomery County. Mount Sterling police took Sabrina Zornes into custody after issuing a warrant for her yesterday. She is held on charges of complicity to kidnapping and assault, as well as tampering with evidence. Police had arrested Kyle Lambert, Lonnie Thomas, and Samuel Pennington yesterday ahead of Zornes' arrest after they located a car that a victim who said they were being kidnapped was in. The victim was allegedly screaming for help, being held by the three men, and allegedly they were covered in the victim's blood. The three men are charged with kidnapping of an adult and second-degree assault, and all are held in the Montgomery County Detention Center. For more stories such as these, be sure to visit Richmond's very own WBONTV.com. I'm Marissa Hempel.